Good morning students, today's topic is relative density. So first we will explain about what is the relative density. Now relative, the word you all know, what is the meaning of relative? Relative means, now if you, I will tell you, relative, a relation between your mother and you, means something we are relating with both of you, okay, means son and mother or daughter and mother. Similarly here it is the relative density. Here also we are going to relate the density with something. What is that something? We are going to relate the density of any substance with the density of water. That's why it is called as relative density. Means we are going to relate the density of any substance to the density of water at 4 degrees Celsius. Okay, so I will tell you, I will explain you first what is relative density. It is the ratio of density of substance to the density of water at 4 degrees Celsius. Why 4 degrees Celsius? Because at 4 degrees Celsius, water shows the maximum density of any substance. That's why we have taken at 4 degrees Celsius. Okay, same we have written in statement, RD means relative density equal to density of substance divided by density of water at 4 degrees Celsius. So here density is again split. You have studied the density, it is the mass per unit volume. Same I have split for this density of substance and this density of water. Here density of substance is written as mass of substance divided by volume of substance, divided by density of water is again split into mass of water divided by volume of water at 4 degrees Celsius. Okay, now what happened? Now we will convert this equation. This term is, as it is divided, this will go here and it will be written as inverted, such as mass of substances divided by volume of substances into this volume will go above, means volume of water divided by mass of water. Okay, now again what happens to the statement? You can see here, this is the relative density statement in the form of mass and volume. Now by solving this, if you are getting the value greater than 1, then greater than 1, then what happens? Sink in water. If the relative density is less than 1, substance will float on water. I will tell you an example. When you are putting an ice cube in the glass, you can see the ice cube float on water. Why it is like that? Because ice cube has a cage like structure. Okay, in that cage is what happened, it is filled with the air inside that, and what happens, it becomes, the density becomes less. And that's why when you put that ice cube in the water, it floats on water. Okay, because ice cube has less density than water. That's why we are comparing any substance with the water and we are finding the relative density. Okay, this part is very important for the problem solving. While the problem solving, if you get the relative density greater than 1, then you can identify the substance can sink in water. And if you are getting the relative density less than 1, then you can see the substance float on water. Okay, then what happens if the volume of both the substances same? Then what will happen if the volume of substance, any substance, and if the volume of water is same? That time what happens over here? We will see. If both are same, then this both statement will get cancelled. You will get mass of substance divided by mass of water at 4 degrees Celsius. Okay, then this statement you are getting. And what is the density of water? The density of water which you are going to use for solving problems is, you are going to take at 4 degrees Celsius, is 1000 kg per centimeter cube equal to, you can also write it as in gram also, 1 gram per centimeter cube.